Hi everyone! Today we're going to talk about what to do with those tomato plants at the end of the growing season. Now if you live in a colder climate and your first frost date is approaching, or if you're in a warmer climate like I am and your tomato plants are reaching the end of their production and just looking pretty worn out from a long hot summer, then you want to stay tuned to this video for a few tips. Tomato plants definitely have a life cycle. They love the warm summer months. The temperatures of 65 to 85 or 90 degrees, they really thrive under those conditions. But they're cold sensitive plants. Once the cold weather hits and the frost hits, they're pretty much done. Well, several of you northern gardeners who live in a cold winter climate have mentioned to me how sad you are that your summer growing season of all those wonderful warm weather vegetables, including tomatoes, is coming to an end. Maybe you've already had a frost in your area, or maybe you have a frost coming very soon. Or maybe you're a southern gardener like I am, and it's just been a brutal, hot, maybe windy summer. Tomato plants are looking pretty bad. No more tomatoes left on them, and you're ready to take them out and replace them with some more cold-tolerant vegetables that can give you some food over the wintertime. Whatever the case might be, if your tomato plant is looking like this, it's time to take it out, either winterize your garden bed or make room for some more vegetables. Now before you completely remove your tomato plant, you definitely want to harvest all of those tomatoes, the red ones and the green ones. You definitely don't want to let any of them go to waste. Now I'm going to harvest the red ones and also harvest the green ones, and they'll easily ripen up indoors just by putting them in a paper sack, sealing it up, and within a week or so, you're going to have yourself some beautiful red ripe tomatoes to enjoy even when the weather's cold out. Gotta love it, right? I grew up gardening in a large family of seven kids, and we had a humongous garden. And one thing my mom did, I always remember this, is she pulled up the entire tomato plant with tons of green tomatoes and hung it upside down in our basement. And believe it or not, those tomatoes ripened and we could go and pick them in the wintertime. Now, I don't have the space to do that in my house, but if you have a big basement in a cool, darker, dry place in your house that you can hang an entire tomato plant, then I want you to do that and comment below and let me know how it works for you, okay? Now, the cool thing about this method is you don't even need any light. You just need a dark basement or a garage, but you do need temperatures of around 60 to 72 degrees in order for your tomatoes to ripen. How fun would it be to go down into your basement in the wintertime and pick some ripe tomatoes? Well, whether you've harvested your tomatoes because you're afraid of frost damaging them, or you just want to make room for more plants like I am, hopefully you got a bigger harvest than I have. I mean, the heat has just really shut my tomato plants down. This is super simple to do. You just want to take a nice, sharp pair of pruners and just cut the tomato plant at the base of the stem. And you can either remove the whole cage with the entire plant in it, or just remove the plant and leave the cage, which is what I'm gonna do, because I'm gonna go ahead and plant some other vegetables at the base of this cage. I mean, how much easier can it get? I already have a cage in here. But I'm gonna plant some peas, which will climb up over this cage during the winter time and give me some more food to harvest over the winter. Now, once you've taken out your tomato plants, do not dispose of them in the compost pile. You definitely want to throw them away in your green trash can, because tomatoes tend to carry a lot of diseases such as blight, and funguses, and all kinds of things like that. And you don't want that spreading to the rest of your garden when you compost it. These tomato plants have been with me all summer. It's always kind of sad to take them out. I mean, do you guys ever feel that way? Now what you can do if you want to is add some shredded leaf mulch or plant some cover crops, which we'll cover in another video, to your garden beds. And what this does is just help prevent against erosion over the winter time. And huge thing here, guys, it also adds organic material to your soil, brings in the worms, and that way when it comes time for spring planting, you'll be a jump ahead. Now for your southern gardeners who live in a more mild winter climate, don't take out your tomato plants just because the colder months are coming and it's the end of the season. If you still have some nice looking plants like this one behind me that has a lot of green tomatoes on it, I would go ahead and leave it in and you might be able to get it to overwinter. Now, key with this is keep it trimmed up, keep it fertilized, give it that good old tomato boost I talked about in a previous video, and keep an eye on the weather. If you're expecting a frost, even a light frost, you may want to come out and cover your plants either with a frost blanket or with some heavy plastic to help protect it from the frost, because the frost will definitely damage it. But although your production might slow down in the wintertime, there's nothing more fun than coming out into your garden when the weather is chilly and picking yourself a nice red tomato. And by the way, if you do need to cover your plant with plastic, make sure you remove it when the sun comes out so your plant doesn't fry as it gets a little bit warmer during the day. Thank you so much for spending time out here in the garden with me today. It's always a lot of fun. Well, I hope you found this video helpful and now know what to do with your tomato plants at the end of the season. Whether you're expecting frost and planning on taking them out, or whether you're hoping to overwinter a few. So share this video with a friend, subscribe if you haven't already, and comment below. Let me know how your tomato plants are doing. I'd love to hear about it. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you on the next video.